Anybody want anything?
Mike, you have a nail?
Yeah, I'll put a nail.
Anybody want anything?
I'll take a water.
Here in the Madison chain. We've had a huge front come through overnight, rained all morning, got a little bit of a late start because of the rain. Temperatures, air temperature has dropped 20 degrees, so we got cold front conditions, but we're still gonna give her a whirl and hopefully we can get them to go today.
Yeah, with this cool down, we're gonna kind of stick the same game plan we had yesterday, but it should be a little bit more effective in our favor. Usually when the water temps or and air temps drop, we lost a couple degrees in water temps overnight too. And like Brad said, it's 20 degrees cooler today than it was yesterday. So we're gonna have to hit the spots that are holding fish methodically with rubber, especially the big joes, which would really pay off today, and bulldogs, and just fish these spots slowly and hit them hard. And we should be able to get a fish or two to bite. That Joe,
yeah,
didn't he?
Really?
So the Muskies
really ate it. Maybe we better, put that one in the net to do a little surgery.
Alright, where's the release tools at?
Yep.
Yeah, back before the Madison chain was stocked heavily with muskies, this has been a trophy pike fishery. Like Brad was talking about, he was in college years ago here, that he was catching 40-inch plus pike, and get a lot of big pike here also along with the muskies. So when you get ones this size, they're worth catching for sure. And they eat the rubber right along with the muskies. So get a lot of big pike on the big joes. Might have been 45. Slowly swimming behind it, about a foot behind it when I first saw it.
Only able to fish a half day due to severe weather, day one would come to a close. Catching only one pike and raising several muskies, one big girl in the mid 40s. It was time to head back and start thinking about the next day.
Should be able to get a couple on rubber today. So we got some dogs and joes working and shallow invaders. So just gonna maybe change up a few color patterns and should be able to get a few fish to bite today. Thank you. see it when it turned on it?
No, I didn't.
I don't see them now, but it got hotter on the heat.
Hey, Ralph Punzel.
Oh, hey, Ronnie.
Where are you headed?
Great Clips.
You're getting a haircut?
I checked in already. He's in their online check-in.
Online check-in?
It saves you time.
You're getting a haircut.
Why?
Thinking about applying to astronaut school.
That's cool.
Okay, I'll see you, Ronnie.
Next time, save time. Download the online check-in app today. Great Clips. It's gonna be great.
An update.
Day one here in Madison. It's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We've actually had a lot of action. Unfortunately, didn't put anything in the boat yet. I think we saw about 7, 8, 9 fish, I think, about now. And we've had 3 strikes, caught a couple pike. But we do have a front moving in later on this evening. And then we're also going to have, you know, sunset coming up about the same time. So banking on that should be really good.
Fish on, man.
What's the comment you just made?
That's the longest we've gone without having a fish. All right, Brad.
Nice.
All right.
Right on. All right.
That was something, huh? Nice job. Literally cast it. That Big Joe hit the water. Boom, that fish was on. I mean, I don't even think you made one twitch.
I was letting it.
Oh, he hit it on the drop.
Yeah, I was dropping it into a pocket, and
he
hit it on the drop.
Yeah, it's really funny. We're kind of on this weed edge, but it's real sporadic, so we got like clumps. It's not really an edge. It's more like clumps.
Yeah.
And, you know, I saw Jeff kind of looking at his graph, like, okay, there's a clump there and a clump there, and literally you were pitching it, what, 30 feet from the boat, if that?
Yeah, not even. When the sun pops out, I can see the clumps better. That's the problem with the clouds. You can't see them quite as well.
Right.
So I'm just making short casts. Otherwise, if you're making really long casts, it's hard to keep the bait out of the weeds. So I'm making short casts and popping it around the clumps. And I threw it into a pocket in the weeds and just moved the rod, and he came up and inhaled it. So
came unglued on it. It was awesome. This is bite number 4, fish number 1.
Yeah, they've been nipping and not getting a real good hold of it, and finally got one here. That
this one ate it good. Nice starter fish right there. Even smells like musky.
Well, let's get her back in the water. Good starter anyway. Well, let's try and get another one,
right,
guys.
On. Let's get another one and add a little length to it.
Yeah. Yep.
Hey, we'll take them, though.
Little black and yellow Big Joe.
Fish number two, man.
Fire.
A little bit smaller guy.
He ate it pretty good. We'll get him off in the net. At least they're starting to chew finally.
Yeah, finally getting a hold of it.
Instead of just looking at it.
And he's just barely hooked too. Just...
pretty little guy.
Another one on the black and yellow Joe.
Yep. One for the future.
Yeah.
Very nice. Well, that was two quick ones, Jeff.
Yeah, hopefully it continues. Got a little bit more serious, man. Moved a lot of fish today. And there's finally the last 15, 20 minutes here, moved three, one decent one that didn't eat, and then these two smaller ones we just got. So hopefully we can run into a big one here shortly. We have a little feeding window going here.
For 2016, Skeeter is introducing the MX 2040. It comes with the Yamaha SHO and a long list of features that fishermen want. It's a 20-foot fiberglass fishing boat that's perfect for the musky angler and available at an amazing package price. Check out the largest selection of MX 2040s at the Skeeter Boat Center. They're online at skeeterboatcenter.com. Yup, you're gonna want one. We're always dealing with something. It's either super heavy winds, extreme heat, or extreme cold. But one thing is an absolute for sure fact. We have to fish. In our line of work, the show must go on. That's why we depend on Odyssey, the extreme batteries. We buy the best boats, electronics, and fishing equipment. Why would I skimp on the most important piece of equipment? Our batteries.
Right on, man.
Nice. That broke the ice.
Dead on the little one, the
crusher.
Crusher, man.
And we're actually bringing the crusher back, so that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Really, very cool. And it's on the crusher again. That's three in a row.
Man, big head shakes.
Some things are built right from the start, and when it comes to musky rods, the Bulldog Pro Series rods, well, they're that built right thing. The Bulldog Pro Series is tough as nails, I caught her, she's in the bag, piece of equipment I can't do without. These rods pioneered big bait throwing technology, and you know what they say, throw big baits, get big fish.
Welcome to the
Bulldog rods, tough as a dog, and that ain't no bull.
Nicest fish we've seen.
40 something, wasn't it?
Hell yeah. Low 40s for sure.
Wow. Unbelievable. Finally get one that's
active. You mean he hammered it out of him?
Eats on the eight.
That's the way it goes, man.
Can't win.
Oh, you know what? It's one of those typical days when you fish. And we, you know, we've seen a lot of fish, but now we haven't seen one in probably 2.5 hours. And all of a sudden one comes screaming up, eats you at both sides, and then gone. T-boned it good too. No excuses. Just got off. The heartbreak of musky fishing right there. Dang it, that was a nice fish too. Probably one of the nicer ones we've seen today. We've been working a lot of weed edges, and actually how Jeff has the boat positioned is when we're working the edge, we got basically one guy in shallow, one guy in kind of on the edge, and then one guy off the edge. So a lot of times we're doing shallow invader in the shallowest portions, and then a bulldog kind of ripping over those medium, you know, maybe 7, 8, 9 feet. And then I've been on the outer edge, you know, fishing the Big Joe here, down, you know, 9 to 12 feet, sometimes even 15, 18 feet of water. And the nice thing about this lure is, you know, you can, just by your cadence and by slowing it down a little, but by still keeping it moving, you can actually work it right down that edge all the way down. Then the key to the, one of the keys to the bait is once you work it down like this, you know, do that rip up at the boat and a couple twitches, and a lot of times that's when they'll eat it, and you'll see one do that. Of course, I missed him, but you'll see him next to the boat. That's what happened. He came shooting off the bottom, turned him once, and he ate it. And they'll do that a lot to this bait. So, but that's kind of been our program, and it's been working out really well for us.
You got one too? Same fish, maybe?
Look at it. Look, nice spooked. They got a big fucking leaf on that rod. Mine's still here.
Still there?
I saw him a second ago.
Yours still there, Brad?
Nope. Mine flared his gills on it. How big was yours, Brad?
35-ish.
That was 32, 33.
Well, that's about fish number 18 to the boat today. Jeez. I don't know, we just can't get them to open their mouths. I'm not even joking. I'll bet we've had 17 or 18 fish to the boat. Been an interesting day, but I got a good feeling about that little bewitching hour right before dark. They should start eating, as active as they've been.
We've been on this adventure for the last 3 days, and this has been the hot lure, and we only have one left, but we know what to do, right, Dave?
Yeah, Mike, I'm already a step ahead of you. Got it right here on joessportinggoods.com.
Sweet.
Check.
Musk Innovations for 2016 is a redesigned Pro Dog. We've added an extra joint inside the bait so they're extra flexible, and we've taken the weight and we've moved it forward and down, and what that creates is that head down action when you rip the bait, and you get that like curling action like this,
and it really gives it a lot of hop, and you get tons of reaction strikes out of it. It also helps the bait to run a little bit deeper, and now we also have it in the regular size bulldog.
Talk about the Big Joe from Live Action Lures that was just purchased by Muskie Innovations. I've been using these baits for a long, long time and really successful for me. It was one of the first soft plastics that came out for Muskies. These were out in the early 80s. Joe Borgward that originated this bait started making these in his garage in the early 80s, 84, 85, and then they came on the market in the mid to late 80s. But been a real good bait. One thing with it, you need to really make sure you use wire leaders, because when the fish hit them, as you can see on this one, there's a lot of teeth marks in the head of it. So a lot of them will grab it in the head. So don't use fluorocarbon with these, because the fish really like to head shoot them, and most of the big ones really have it in their mouth. And for setup for these, I like using an extra heavy rod. I use a shorter rod, 7.6 extra heavy Muskie Innovations Pro Series rod is a real good one for me. And if you want to work them deep, it's a fairly heavy bait. If you need to work it shallows, all you gotta do is hold your rod up, and I'm not doing any jerking or pulling on the rod. Everything I'm doing, all the action is with the reel, just doing a regular reel. And if I want to drop the bait down or work it deeper, then I just hold my rod tip down. But these things rip and work through weeds extremely well. That's a lot of people think that you can't throw them in and around weeds, and that's a high percentage of time that I'm really working a lot of these baits is in and around the weeds, especially cabbage beds, any of the milfoil like here in the Madison chain works real well for. But a lot of times, if the sun's out, you work a lot of the pockets, like some of the fish we caught yesterday in a real short cast. You can just kind of flip it out and just keep your rod up high and drop it in and around those pockets. I mean, that's great for triggering strikes. And one thing with the Joes is you can't cover a ton of water with them. So the times that I really like to use them is when you're got real bad cold fronts, like today is 20 degrees colder than it was yesterday. So this would be one of the times that I use them. When you're bringing it in, you want to try and keep it down. And then when you're bringing it up, do a couple quick hops up and then go into your figure eight, and don't keep going with the hopping. You just figure eight it the same that you would a bucktail. Up when you're going away from the boat, and then down when you're coming back towards the boat, because you want to keep that fish's attention not on you and on the lure. So up when you're going away from the boat, and down when you're coming towards. And then you don't need to jerk or do any action on the bait. Just figure eight it just like a bucktail, and you'll get a lot more hits that way on it.
I thought that fish was gonna eat it too. Sooner or later, here one of those 40 pluses is going to eat. There it is again.
It's there.
I wonder if I should have you throw that bait like
fast. See if one of those fish bags will eat that way.
I did the reach on it, so I'm kind of hooked, man.
Good job. Good net job. Holy smokes, man.
Nice job, Mike.
Woo. I'll tell you what, guys, that was... Jeff just had this fish up, and he tried figure eight, and it took off, and he's like, Mike, He's like, throw, he goes, throw back on that fish and reel that shallow invader as fast as you can. I cranked her back, went into my turn, she came up and smoked it.
Yeah.
All right, whew, on the board.
Yeah, she got unhooked right.
Boy, I'll tell you what, guys, we've really, really had a tough time here. I mean, we have had probably, I don't know how many fish to the boat, and for some reason, they're just not eating. Finally, we got one to eat here. Nice fish.
Yep.
Dandy, finally. You know, guys, I'll tell you what, we're all big, you know, fans of Muskies Inc., and it's lakes like this here in Madison that they have stocked, and you're seeing the benefits of it.
Yeah, the fishing here has gotten better and better. I mean, the fishing here now is better than it's ever been. I mean, I've fished this lake since I was a little kid, and there's more muskies in here now than there ever has been before, and that's because of the Capital City Chapter of Muskies, Inc. I mean,
and also the DNR, they've put in here, too. They've also put some spotted leech lakers in here.
Yep, yeah, they're just, now the biggest ones I've had in the boat are like 46 and a half, but within about 2 years here, we should start to have a lot more 50-inch class fish here in the Madison chain, so it's going to be, the best years are yet to come here.
We raised some dandy fish we're going to go back on tonight, but it's been a tough bite. Yeah. But you know, Jeff, it's musky fishing, and this time of the year, the windows are short, and you just got to hang in there like we've done, and good things will happen.
Yeah, I mean, we've had a few chances. They're just short hitting and nipping at it, and we've lost a couple at the side of the boat that hit on figure eights, and I mean, we've seen almost 20 fish now, and it's just finally got one in the net. And
well, everybody, that concludes this week's show of Keys Outdoors. I'll tell you what, Jeff, we had nice fish up. We had a ton of fish, but it just wasn't in the cards for us, man. We had fish that bit and got off. It was like just bad luck for us. But I'll tell you what, this is an awesome fishery here. It is a lot of fun. And I'll tell you what, if you guys would like to get a hold of Jeff and make an adventure like this, a reality, it's real simple. How do they get a hold of you?
You can go to my website, MadisonMuskieGuide.com is the best way to get a hold of me. You can see all the pictures, all the big fish from Madison. All my guide information is all on there, and all the other information, my email and phone numbers are all on that, MadisonMuskieGuide.com, so you can find me that way.
Hey everybody, I'm Mike Keys. I don't know where we're gonna be, but I do guarantee you this, like always, it will be an adventure. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all next week. Keys Outdoors and Quick Trip have teamed up once again for another Muskie Adventure Contest. One lucky winner and a guest will spend a day out on the water with Mr. Dave Brown. But that's not all. You will also receive a $100 Quick Trip gift card. To enter, text KEYS to 77887. Message and data rates may apply. For official rules and free means to enter, visit quicktrip.com. Keys Outdoors would not be possible without the support of these awesome sponsors.